Statements made during this broadcast regarding products or the claims made about specific products have not been evaluated by the U.S. Food and Drug Administration. Products and treatments discussed are not intended to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent disease. Make your physician aware of all nutritional supplements used and immediately notify your physician if you have any health concern or undiagnosed sign or symptom. Let's Talk Nutrition is a health talk show that features scientists, authors, nutrition specialists, personal trainers, holistic healers, and experts in traditional, natural, and integrative medicine. Listen for a chance to win daily prizes and follow Let's Talk Nutrition on Facebook and Instagram at Let's Talk Nutrition or on Twitter at LTN Radio. It's time for some inspiration. Tune in to get fit and healthy. It's time to talk about nutrition. Nutrition for your body, your mind, your spirit. It's time to talk about proper exercise, stress relief, eating well, and supplementation to help. Get ready to take charge of your health because your health is your wealth and the wealth of those who care about and love you. It's time for Let's Talk Nutrition with Dr. Michael Garko. Welcome to the show.
Well, if you want to talk about nutrition, okay, we'll do that. Welcome to Let's Talk Nutrition. Great to be with you. Thanks for tuning in today, as always. Appreciate your listenership. And got some territory to cover today, some interesting things to talk about, hopefully that will resonate with you and maybe make it, who knows, you never know, make a difference in your life, in your health. You may catch on to, you may hear something that, you know, catches your ear and you say, you know what, maybe I should try that, or maybe I should think about that. Well, we'll see. I'm going to talk a little in a little bit with my guest, Hamilton. Done. Okay. We're going to talk about enzymes today. And I know that many people are aware of enzymes, and they usually think of them as associated with digestion, and that's true, but there's something else that goes on with them. And Hamilton Cabanella, I'm going to see if I can get him to talk about it a little bit, how they may help you in managing inflammation. And you may say, what? Yeah. And this is this particular therapy, enzyme therapy for inflammation, is not necessarily a new idea. Many people know about it, but I think there's more that don't know than know. It's my opinion, if I had to guess. And it works. It's been around a while, and it works. And Hamilton may have something else he wants to talk about, but I would like him to comment on that, because there are more than a few people on this planet, and more than a few perhaps that even listen to this show, that have inflammation issues. That's just, yeah. Including me, as always, you know. Inflammation is a consequence of your immune system reacting either to an infection or an injury, which is a good thing. But when the inflammation doesn't get turned off, boy, it can cause a lot of discomfort and even a lot of damage. So it's when a good thing goes bad. All right, 877-897-8255, 877-897-TALK. Let's see. Have some good news for a change. It's always nice, right? And this is a study that comes out of University of Copenhagen, the Faculty of Health and Medical Sciences, and it dials into a topic that I address a lot on this show, and that's obesity and, you know, weight loss and how do you do it, and why is it so hard, and why do people fail at it, and so few succeed? It's a narrative that is that many resonate with, for sure. Well, there's some good news. And what they were trying to, the way it has worked so far is with people is that they can lose the weight. Then they have a devil of a time keeping the weight off. And some may say, well, it has something to do totally with their willpower. Not necessarily. Not necessarily. And I'll explain. The study will give me an opportunity to share that with you and give you some insight into why it's so difficult. And it, maintaining a stable weight, after you lose the weight, maintaining that stable weight is probably among the most biggest challenges for people who are obese. In fact, even people who are overweight. But this new piece of research provides some insights into the complex processes that are involved in obesity, especially weight loss and obesity. And they said that, and I'll quote them, "It is now possible to offer people a clear understanding of how to sustain weight loss," close quote. Well, I'm eager to have that. The study shows that if an overweight person can maintain an initial weight loss, and in the study it turned out to be for 1 year, the body will eventually adjust and adapt and accept the new weight and not fight against it, as is otherwise normally the case when a person is in a calorie deficit state. So said Professor Sorensen Torikov from the Department of Biomedical Sciences. What happens here is when you lose the weight, the body recorded what's called a set point. The weight that you were at when you started to lose the weight sort of gets coded, set. And as you're losing the weight, the body wants to do what? The biology is it wants to take you back to that point. That's what it wants to do. And hence, that's part of the reason why people struggle to keep the weight off. And they've been trying to figure this out. Why, you know, why is that the case? Probably has something to do with evolution and during feast and famine and what the body biologically evolved to remember the weight that you were at. Now that you're losing weight, the body doesn't know or care. Well, it knows if you're obese, but it's trying to keep you. It's wanting you to survive. So it's saying, "I will help you remember how much weight you were where you were at when you started to lose the weight, and I'll get you back there so you don't starve to death." I that's a hypothesis. I'm guessing that's what might be going on here. That's one possible explanation. So you're fighting against that sort of evolutionary biological tendency. And so in this study, these overweight people, when they lost the weight, and if they could keep it off for a year, then the body seemed to accept the new weight and not try to force them back to the old weight. That's good news. In other words, up till this point, much of the work has said, you know what, you're sort of stuck and you're just going to have to keep struggling. And I'll quote them now. "The main finding in the study revealed that after 1 year of successful weight loss maintenance, the researchers were able to demonstrate that postprandial, that means after eating, levels of two appetite-inhibiting hormones, they're called GLP-1 and PYY, increased." What that means is that the appetite was inhibited from before weight loss level, in contrast to the hunger hormone, which is called ghrelin, which increased immediately after weight loss. See what the body's doing? When you're losing weight, the body sees that as an emergency situation. It releases ghrelin, which makes you hungry, because, again, dealing with evolution, feast and famine, and nature's tendency is to want to keep you alive, and it's thinking, uh-oh, there's a famine. This person's losing weight. We got to stimulate. Got to stimulate this person to eat. Ghrelin's released. So this demonstrates that these hormones, this what they're called GLP-1 and PYY, are able. The data suggests that these hormones will adjust to the new set point. That's good news. And then we'll facilitate the person's success in maintaining their new weight. So there's a, I know that that, to me, that's a piece of good news, because now if we can, if you can get that person to keep that weight off for a year, which is a long time, that's a new set point will be created, and now you won't have to struggle as hard. Hamilton Caminello will be my guest. We're going to talk about enzymes. I want to ask him to just, if he can, talk about it relative to inflammation. That may be new information to some people, and he'll lay it out. You'll see. He's very good.
As a family-owned company since 1968, Now Foods has spent the last 46 years building a legacy in the natural health industry as a trusted leader. Now provides a comprehensive approach to wellness by offering more than 1,400 high-quality health foods, supplements, sports nutrition, and personal care products at an affordable price. Now believes that natural is better. They don't use artificial colors, flavors, or sweeteners, and they offer many vegetarian, organic, and gluten-free products. Their foods are all non-GMO. Since their beginning, Now has grown to become an award-winning leader in the natural health industry. But one thing has never changed: their commitment to providing the highest quality products at the best value to empower people to lead healthier lives. High quality doesn't have to mean high price. From essential oils to amino acids, multivitamins to natural sweeteners, Now has you covered. To find a store near you that carries Now products, or for more information, visit nowfoods.com. That's nowfoods.com.
At Canavest, we believe that the future of hemp is unlimited, and through innovative and responsible application in science, we will enhance the prosperity and well-being of our customers, employees, and communities. As pioneers, our long-term goal at Canavest is to locate hemp seed processing mills near to our future family of hemp farmers. These local factories will convert hemp seed into nutritious oil, protein powders, bread flour, and hemp meal. Canavest supports local efforts and believes that sustainability starts locally. Canavest was named one of the Nutritional Outlook's Best of 2014, and we are committed to pioneering the hemp revolution as the world's leading producer of quality hemp-derived CBD products. Resistance to change is in great part the result of trying to do today's job with yesterday's tools and with yesterday's concepts. The hemp revolution is here, and it's up to all of us to change perception and to impact policy. Will you join us in this movement? Learn more about the education and science behind Canavest at canavest.com.
Did you know that when it comes to supporting whole body health, there's an herbal supplement that may be as important as your daily multivitamin? Discover Zyflamend Whole Body from New Chapter, formulated to support a whole body healthy inflammation response, an ongoing natural process and part of the body doing its job. We often think of the inflammation response as something we can feel, such as where there are sensitive nerve endings. But did you know that we can also have an inflammation response we can't feel? And whether we are aware of it or not, our inflammation response can affect the whole body. Zyflamend is a patented blend of 10 remarkable herbs, including pure and potent turmeric, that help balance and support your body's natural, healthy inflammation response for overall health and wellness. And it's clinically tested. Discover the premier herbal supplement for whole body health from New Chapter, Zyflamend Whole Body. These statements have not been evaluated by the Food and Drug Administration. This product is not intended to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent any disease. Available at your local fine health food store.
When you're passionate about your health, that passion leads to the knowledge that exercise and a healthy diet are not always enough. Sometimes you need the extra nutritional boost that only supplements can provide. If you are looking for the leading national brands of vitamins, supplements, health and beauty, weight loss, or sports nutrition products, look no further than Vitamin Discount Center. Voted Best Independent Chain by Vitamin Retailer Magazine, Vitamin Discount Center has been a trusted and valuable nutrition resource to the Tampa Bay area for over 15 years. With daily savings up to 50%, Vitamin Discount Center offers the best prices on the highest quality nutritional supplements. Not only will you find unbeatable value, your visit includes access to a staff educated on the application of products to help equip you with the products and information you need to proactively improve your health. To locate the store nearest you, visit vitamindiscountcenter.com, as well as access to articles on popular health topics, promotions, events, and thousands of products to shop from right at home. Your search for an affordable solution to better health is finally over. Vitamin Discount Center. For life, for less.
Let's Talk Nutrition is brought to you by Natrol, Own Your Health, Algalife, Algae for Life, NeoCell, the true science of collagen, CV Sciences, from seed to shelf, New Chapter, the benefit of nature's wisdom, Yerba Prima, pioneers in internal cleansing, Form Essentials, makers of the sleep aid Solace, now introducing Zinnia for healthy hair, skin, and nails. Let's Talk Nutrition on the web at letstalknutrition.com. We're back from the break, so let's rejoin Dr. Michael Garko.
Welcome to Let's Talk Nutrition. Welcome back. If you were already dialed in, and if you just tuned in, thanks for stopping by. My guest is Hamilton Cabanella. He's an educator for Enzymedica. And I want to get him to talk a little bit about enzyme therapy or use of enzymes relative to inflammation. Now, this topic is not without difference of opinion and controversy. And if you caught on to this show, My genetic instinct and tendency is always to find that. And then because, you know, we want to deal with that. I'm not going to run away from disagreement and this and that. No, that's where we want to go. That's where the action is, right? People don't look at parked cars. They look at wrecks, right? Unless it's a beautiful Maserati sitting there parked. People will watch an auto wreck, you know, crash, but they're not going to sit there and watch cars parked. The same thing with controversy. It's like watching an auto wreck. Hamilton, welcome back to the show. It's great to have you on.
Good morning, Dr. Garko. How are you today?
I'm good. What do you make of this idea of using enzymes to help with inflammation?
Oh, phenomenal idea. It's nothing new. It's nothing, you know, we'd like to take credit as a company. Yeah, Enzymedica created it, but no, it's been around a long, long time. Enzymes from anything like pineapple, from papaya, have been used probably millenniums to deal with inflammation, with injuries and such.
Okay. Bear with me, okay? And don't panic. Whatever you do, don't panic. Don't say.
Well, I'm nervous.
Don't
you
do that.
Nervous, Doc.
Stay calm. Stay calm. I went online, and I started rooting around, and I came across an article by Dr. Weil. You know who that is, right? Andrew Weil or Weil? Andrew
yes, Weil. Sir.
Okay. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna quote from his article. And he says, enzymes are specialized protein molecules that catalyze, otherwise speed up, biochemical reactions. He's right about that. That's what they do. He said they're involved in all aspects of metabolism, growth, and development, but there is generally no point in taking them as supplements. I'm quoting him. Just bear with me. Don't panic. The reason is simple. Enzymes that are ingested are simply broken down in the stomach and small intestine and digested like any other proteins. The only exceptions are the digestive enzymes made by the stomach and pancreas, which work in the gastrointestinal tract, and I occasionally recommend digestive enzyme supplements to patients who have digestive problems, close quote. So far, you're following his point of view, right?
So far, yeah.
Okay. He said... However, the pointlessness of taking systemic enzymes orally hasn't stopped promoters of systemic enzyme therapy from making many claims about the benefits of their products, close quote. I guess he's including you and me. Now, that being, keep him in mind, okay? You got him in your head, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then I went and I looked at Joe Mercola. I like Dr. Mercola. You know Joseph Mercola, right?
Yes, sir.
You know who I'm talking about. You always make me nervous when you call me sir. Dr. Mercola has a completely different point of view. And he says enzymes drive biological processes necessary for your body to build raw materials, circulate nutrients, eliminate unwanted chemicals, and the myriad of other biochemical processes that go on without you ever thinking about it. And then he says, for starters, here are just some of the activities in your body requiring enzymes. energy production, absorption of oxygen, fighting infections and healing wounds, reducing inflammation, getting nutrients into your cells, carrying away toxic waste, dissolving blood clots. It goes on and on. Proper hormone regulation, slowing aging, the aging process. So Dr. McCullough has a completely different view than Dr. Weil or Dr. Weil, doesn't he?
Right.
Okay. Now that I laid that out there, I'm going to sit back and let you comment on what both of those guys said. Then I'll chime in. Welcome to the show.
Thanks for throwing me right into the frying pan.
You enter. Go ahead.
Here's the thing. Dr. Weil, very familiar with his work, love his work, great nutritional advice and, you know, natural health advice, been around a while. But technology and, you know, natural supplements and the development of these things, you know, change frequently. They change during the years. I think Dr. Weil, in the case of natural, you know, enzyme supplements, kind of learned something way back when, you know, when he, you know, did his research, did his studies, and held on to that belief. Which is what happens, believe it or not. I work a lot with medical doctors, you know, who go to whatever 12, 16 years of school, whatever they do, and sometimes have the same thought process that, you know, enzymes get destroyed by stomach acid, they can't be absorbed, et cetera. So they held on to that belief that was taught in their biology class, et cetera, but don't follow the ongoing research, the ongoing technology changes in what's been developed in the enzyme world, and just, you know, hold on to that, that original belief.
Okay, kind of, so like when we come back, when we come back, I'll give you a chance to explain what that new technology is and how it is that enzymes can help with inflammation and all the other things that Dr. McCullough says they can do. And I happen to line up with him on this. By the way, I'll tell you a little story about Dr. Weil when we come back.
When your alarm goes off, do you jump out of bed with excitement? Or does it take multiple alarms, a few snooze buttons, or a morning caffeine fix to get you going? These habits and daily stress cause a vicious cycle in which sleep becomes increasingly elusive. In fact, 54% of Americans report struggles to fall or stay asleep. For a better night's rest, look no further than Solace, an all-natural dietary supplement that supports healthy sleep and relaxation so you get the rest you need to wake up clear-eyed, alert, and ready for the day. Solace has given thousands a better night's rest and the power to take back their mornings while enjoying the day ahead of them. Solace is formulated with non-addictive, scientifically proven, all-natural ingredients that support sleep and relaxation, such as melatonin, tryptophan, and 5-HTP. For more information or to order Solace, visit TakeSolace.com. Solace, for healthy sleep, naturally.
Looking for the perfect complement to your beauty regimen? Try Form Essentials Zinnia. The finest of its kind, Zinnia offers twice as much biotin as other formulas, which has proven to unlock the vibrancy in even the dullest of hair, skin, and nails. Zinnia breaks through and rejuvenates cells internally, helping you achieve the allure of effortless beauty. Reviving your hair, skin, and nails has never been easier. This essential blend of biotin, alpha lipoic, and hyaluronic acid, collagen, and vitamin C creates lasting enhancements to your natural good looks. Don't go on wondering, you're worth the results. This combination of ingredients can only be found in Zinnia. Pamper yourself with a proven bit of affordable luxury and start looking your best. Ask for Zinnia by name at your nearest vitamin retailer to begin your journey to restored nails, head-turning hair, and radiant skin today. For more information, visit formessentials.com.
Let's Talk Nutrition is brought to you by Now Foods. Our products work. American Biotech Labs, your daily immune system support. Renew Life, the digestive care company. Country Life, a leader and authority in natural health and nutrition. Enzymedica, the enzyme experts. Nutrix Hawaii, more nutrition, better health, purely Hawaiian. North American Urban Spice, the only oregano oil you can take on a daily basis. Let's Talk Nutrition, on the web at letstalknutrition.com. We're back from the break, so let's rejoin Dr. Michael Garko.
Every person listening to this show or watching it has had the experience of inflammation. Welcome back to Let's Talk Nutrition. And as people age, the odds of suffering from inflammation that is chronic increases, because the aging process being what it is, people having arthritis or any other kind of chronic disease will have inflammation. And the question becomes, how are you going to manage it? It's intended to do a good thing. It's to help the body fight foreign invaders, if you will, viruses and whatnot. And it's also intended to help the body heal from an injury of one sort or another. So it's a good thing, but can be problematic if not turned off. Can do a lot of damage to the joints. It can do a lot of damage to tissue, and so on and so on. And for a long time in the world of natural health and medicine, naturopaths and the like have talked about enzymes and enzyme therapy. My guest is Hamilton Cabanella. Hamilton, Dr. Howe was a proponent of enzyme therapy, wasn't he?
Absolutely. He was the George Washington of enzyme therapy.
Mm-hmm. And did he talk about using enzymes for purposes of managing or moderating inflammation?
Well, yeah. He felt they were at the foundation of all reactions in the body, and they were the workforce. So whether digestive, whether immune support, whether inflammation, they were the little soldiers, the little policemen that were allowing these reactions to take place. So absolutely.
Mm-hmm. So Dr. Wheel, he's not a fan, obviously, given the quote that I read to you, right? And I didn't do that. I wasn't doing gotcha journalism here or try to trap you and get you into some. I was trying to point out that even some prominent people in the world of health and medicine, both allopathically and naturopathically, disagree with this point of view. And they're entitled to do that. And I don't shy right. away from that. And I think it's more honest for the listener and the viewer to know that there are different points of view. And I'm willing to deal with that, because I think we can make a pretty convincing argument that these enzymes can work in the way that we're talking about at the moment. So you said that the technology has changed such that the enzymes, what were you getting at, rather than me saying it, what were you getting at relative to technology and enzymes?
Right. And in simplest terms, basically enzyme therapy began using animal-sourced enzymes. So enzymes from the pancreas of a pig, from a cow, from different organs from animals.
Mm-hmm.
Those particular enzymes way back when, were used, for different purposes, digestively, cancer therapy, different things like that. But they were much more fragile structures. So yes, they didn't survive stomach acid very well, because again, they were coming from a pancreas of another creature, of another animal. So they were designed to work in alkaline environments. So really, they needed to be protected. They needed to get to our small intestine. Through the years, technology changed. We're able to source enzymes from plant sources, microbial sources, fungal sources, cleaner, but also more potent and stronger enzymes that can basically survive pretty much any type of environment. I mean, there's microorganisms living at the bottom of volcanoes in the depth of oceans, in the harshest environment, and they produce enzymes. So those are the enzymes that we're able to use today, with, again, giving us a much greater survivability and ability to use in different types of therapies.
So the enzymes from Enzymedica, and I'm speaking now of the systemic enzymes, or as they're sometimes called, the proteolytic enzymes. Can you talk about those for a second and what they are and how it is that they can survive the stomach acid and so on?
Absolutely. And as a company, Enzymedica, we're a 100% vegetarian company. So we don't use any animal-sourced enzymes. And there's many advantages to that. There are vegetarian enzymes are much cleaner in that sense. You don't have to worry where the animal, you know, was raised, what kind of hormones, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. But they're also much more potent. So the amount of enzymes you would need to take of an animal-based one compared to a vegetarian enzyme, you know, a much higher amount of the animal-based enzyme. They have to be protected. Again, they don't like acid environment, and it's a much more fragile structure, if you want to call it that. When they come in contact with acid, they could actually denature or break, if you will, and stop functioning. Mm-hmm. While in the case of the vegetarian enzyme, they survive acid, you know, just fine, get to the environment they're, you know, going to work in and have wonderful success. So that's what we have developed, enzymes that are designed to work in the wonderful pH of your blood, which is a very steady pH, 7.35 to 7.45. So these vegetarian enzymes that work in that environment,
right,
can, again, get to your bloodstream and support all the wonderful functions. Again, inflammation, cardiovascular,
right,
immune, you name it. There's enzymes that can help with that.
Clearly. 877-897-8255 is a toll-free number. You're listening to Hamilton Cabanella. Is it Caban? How do you say it?
Either way, Cabanella, Spanish, Cabanilla, whatever rolls off your tongue.
I was going to say Cabanilla, but I thought, you know, I better not. I didn't want to mispronounce. So Cabanella or Cabanilla?
There you go.
What did your mother call you?
She said it was in Spanish, so Cabanilla.
Okay, there you go. So, now, assume for a moment that enzyme therapy relative to, I'm just focusing on inflammation, works. Now, there are certain enzymes, and I wanted to ask you about one. Serrapeptase, isn't mm-hmm. that, is that one of the, is that one of the featured enzymes that helps with inflammation?
Absolutely. That is not only for inflammation, but it's probably the most multifaceted enzyme in existence at the moment.
And by the way, there are clinical trials with serrapeptase. I even found a study where people had carpal tunnel syndrome, and they did a trial with these people, and they found that the enzyme therapy help to moderate some of the inflammation or side effects associated with carpal tunnel. And there are other clinical trials with serrapeptase, that particular enzyme, and there are other clinical trials with these systemic enzymes as well. So it's not, these enzymes are not without some clinical evidence to support the claims. 877-897-8255. Hamilton Cabanilla is my guest today. And he's an educator for Enzymedica. We'll be right back.
At Country Life Vitamins, we've been helping people live happy, healthy lives since 1971. And we believe integrity should always be our number one ingredient. We are committed to this belief because you deserve high-quality nutrition, specifically crafted with the highest standards to support your health. Country Life's manufacturing facility is an NSF GMP-registered facility, as well as USDA-certified organic, so you can feel good about the products you're taking. Country Life Vitamins is also the first supplement company in the United States to have a complete line of products certified gluten-free. That's over 500 products. Country Life Vitamins' pledge of integrity is based on five standards: authenticity, cleanliness, freshness, consistency, and accuracy. Ask for Country Life's top-selling products, such as Coenzyme B Advanced for increased energy or Flexable for joint health. Country Life Vitamins' commitment to ensure all of our products are pure, wholesome, gluten-free supplements full of natural goodness provides peace of mind with the knowledge you are using a brand you can trust.
Exclusively from Natural Factors. I'm Dr. Michael Murray. I'm very excited to have the opportunity to talk with you about PGX, a truly revolutionary natural product that works perfectly to help get at the core issues that make weight loss so difficult. PGX is a clinically proven way to help people to achieve their ideal body weight that is safe and natural. PGX leads to a dramatic reduction in the glycemic index of any food or meal. It also ultimately causes the release of compounds that achieve two important goals in weight loss. One, telling your brain that you're satisfied so you eat less, and two, improving the action of the hormone insulin. If you've ever tried to lose weight and failed, it's not your fault. You just need the tremendous support that PGX can provide. For more information on making your weight loss dream a near effortless reality, please go to PGX.com.
At Nordic Naturals, we know that a commitment to deliver the world's safest, most effective omega oils requires an exceptional process. That's why we manage every step of production from boat to bottle. That includes sustainably sourcing wild-caught fish from well-managed fisheries. It means using state-of-the-art equipment and technology at our manufacturing plant in Arctic Norway. Nordic Naturals bottles and encapsulates our omega-3s at our own facility and carefully ships products from our eco-friendly headquarters in California. The result? Nordic Naturals products have received more than 40 awards for taste, innovation, and product excellence. You can trust the quality of Nordic Naturals products and know you're getting all the health benefits omega-3 fish oils offer. Nordic Naturals' high-quality, great-tasting omega-3s make staying healthy easier for you and your family. When choosing an omega-3 fish oil product, choose the number one fish oil in the U.S. Choose Nordic Naturals. Available at natural product retailers or online at nordicnaturals.com.
Are you waking up each day to the life you have to live or to the life you want to live? Better health shouldn't be left to chance. Smart choices to living longer and stronger include making Kyolic Aged Garlic Extract a part of your daily routine. For years, medical researchers have recommended adding Kyolic to the diet as a powerful tool to enhancing overall heart and immune health. Recent clinical studies at UCLA Medical Center using Kyolic suggest that garlic may slow plaque formation in the arteries and support healthy cholesterol and homocysteine levels. Previous research also shows Kyolic may enhance your immune system defenses. Kyolic is organic, odorless, and the only antioxidant garlic supplement available worldwide. Maintaining a healthier you could extend your life. Your wellness begins with Kyolic Aged Garlic Extract, available everywhere fine nutritional supplements are sold. Visit Kyolic.com, that's K-Y-O-L-I-C.com, or call 1-800-421-2998 for a free sample today.
Is your skin showing signs of aging? Do you want hair with more body and stronger nails? Add NeoCell's Super Collagen Plus C to your daily routine to help you regain your youthful, vibrant appearance. Collagen is the body's key structural protein, and it is critical to the elasticity and strength of connective tissues like skin, ligaments, and tendons. Recent clinical studies suggest that supplementing with collagen may reduce wrinkles and increase the firmness of your skin, improve the thickness of your hair, and strengthen your nails. Previously, medical studies also show a wide range of benefits from collagen supplements that may help with your joint pain, bone strength, and exercise recovery. NeoCell's Super Collagen Plus C provides 100% pure collagen that's hydrolyzed for maximum absorption. Results are felt and seen within weeks. Super Collagen Plus C promotes a healthy body by providing specialized nutritional support to help fight the effects of aging. NeoCell's Super Collagen Plus C products are available everywhere fine nutritional supplements are sold.
Let's Talk Nutrition is brought to you by Nubian Heritage, Global Healing, Modern Wellness, BSN, Finish First, Nordic Naturals, Pure and Great Tasting Omega Oils, Jaro Formulas, Superior Nutrition and Formulation, Natural Factors, Where Great Health Begins, Kyolic, Aging Makes the Finest Garlic Truly Odorless, A. Vogel, Europe's Leading Brand of Herbal Medicine, Let's Talk Nutrition, on the web at letstalknutrition.com. We're back from the break, so let's rejoin Dr. Michael Garko.
And we're back, and thanks for tuning in today. My guest is Hamilton Cabanilla, and he's an educator for Enzymedica. Hamilton, welcome back. So how come you got it like a gringo first name, Hamilton? How come it's not Carlos?
funny thing. My parents, you know, they moved to New York from Ecuador, and there's a street in New York City called Hamilton. Saw the street, knew the president, liked the name, bam, here I am.
Yeah, like, you know, I thought it would be something like Carlos Cabanilla, you know, who sounds like a baseball player, right? Plays for the Yankees. Just trying to keep you awake, Hamilton. You know, I don't want you to fall off on me.
Appreciate it. Appreciate it.
I always enjoy having you on. You have a sense of humor and you go with the flow, man. By the way, speaking of New York and streets, I was up in New York, and you know, parking is terrible there, right? You can't finding a parking space. You have a better chance being an astronaut. So we're driving around, and you come to this one corner, and it was not in the main part of Manhattan. It's like one of these off streets, and there was a sign, a city issued sign, and it said on the sign, "Don't even think about it." It didn't say no parking or anything like that. It just said, "Don't even think about it." Only in New York, right? "Don't even think about it."
Oh my.
Pretty good, no? All right.
Oh my
gosh. Yeah, you got to love that. So, proteolytic. That means protein destroying. I guess that's what that means, right? Proteolytic?
Correct. It's just another fancy word for proteases that work on proteins.
Okay. And enzymes are proteins, right?
Correct.
And the proteolytic,
yeah,
you correct me if I get this list wrong. Are the following typically considered the proteolytic enzymes? Bromelain, papain, pancreatin, trypsin, chymotrypsin, rutin, serrapeptase, are those considered proteolytic, or do the digestive enzymes become proteolytic as well?
Well, they haven't been too creative with the names of enzymes, so all of those you mentioned are types of proteases, and then there's another 100 that are just called proteases. So, you know, some got names like Hamilton, like I did, some are just called proteases, and there's a few hundred of them, but all of those are proteases.
Okay. And the main, I mean, other than being different by not only name, but what they are, structure and function, one of the main differences between digestive and proteolytic, you want to take the proteolytic on an empty stomach. Isn't that right?
That's correct. It's basically where they are able to perform their job, where they're able to have high activity. The main difference between a digestive and a, you know, proteolytic or systemic or therapeutic is just that, where they work. You know, digestive prefer, you know, acid environments or alkaline environments. You know, they want to work in your digestive tract.
Mm-hmm.
Our systemic ones are designed to work, again, in that very steady pH of your blood, which, again, 7.35 to 7.45, very steady pH. That's where you want a systemic enzyme to thrive in.
So let's say a person has osteoarthritis in his or her hands. Well, in taking the systemic enzymes, how is it that the enzymes will get to the hands? Is it just because of it's coursing through the blood, and as they go along, they see an inflammatory site and they go there? How does that work?
So what's interesting is enzymes are already used by our natural immune or inflammatory systems. So it isn't anything foreign to your body. Your body loves enzymes, uses enzymes. But again, as we age or different health challenges, we don't produce enough enzymes to take care of the different functions that are occurring. So when you take a supplemental enzyme, like the ones you mentioned, these systemic enzymes, you're just giving more workers to your body system.
Mm-hmm.
So they actually have the ability to bind with certain components of your immune system, alpha-2 macroglobulins, if you want the technical name. But they kind of join up with that. These little guys taxi them or shuttle them to wherever there's inflammation, wherever there's an injury, wherever there's infection, and put the enzymes to work.
And the proteases, which are sometimes referred as proteolytic enzymes or peptidases, are the ones that we're talking about, right?
Correct. Correct. Those are the primary ones, because most of the things that trigger inflammatory responses, you know, whether it's an injury, you know, you were, you know, building something, hit your finger with a hammer, or again, arthritis, or, you know, any overdoing it at the gym, surgery. What's triggering those, you know, inflammatory reactions are usually proteins, whether it's, again, dead cells, dead tissues, you know, muscle or skin that's been cut, whatever it is, or blood clots themselves. Again, we get injured, there's going to be blood clots in that area. All of those are protein structures that need to be broken down and eliminated so the inflammation goes away and the healing begins. That's all these proteases are really helping. They're the cleanup crew.
So if somebody had surgery, let's say plastic surgery, and whatever, on the face or some part of the body, and there's and the surgeon's making incisions with a scalpel, and you're going to form scar tissue.
Right.
Would it be a good idea for people, for example, that are going to have surgery, to take the proteolytic enzymes after surgery to help with scarring or potential scarring?
Absolutely. And like you mentioned, there's research. It isn't just, you know, well, Enzymedic is saying it. No, there's research. There's studies on knee surgery. There's a recent study in Germany on knee surgery. About 66 patients, half got a placebo, half got a serrapeptase supplement. It sped up the recovery time, the healing time, the pain-free time for those that took that proteolytic supplement in half.
Wow.
There's other studies on you know, dental surgery, you know, removing different, you know, molars, teeth, et cetera. You know, that usually causes a lot of swelling in the face. Took a proteolytic supplement, you know, for some didn't. Again, minimal inflammation, minimal swelling in the face. So many studies, a lot of research, you know, athletes in Germany, hockey players, karate fighters, different studies on them. Phenomenal recovery time on the ones that use enzymes, because you're just adding workers to your enzymatic workforce.
There you go. That's Hamilton Cabanilla. If you're watching the show, we had an image of him up there. It looks like his first Holy Communion picture. I don't know where we got that image of you. You look so, you know, you're a nice guy. I mean, you can see from the picture. Very nice. He's usually in studio, but today he couldn't make it. He couldn't make the drive over, but we always appreciate having him on. We'll bring him back for the second portion of the show, and he'll cut out a little early today. We'll be back.
Hi. statements made during this broadcast regarding products or the claims made about specific products have not been evaluated by the U.S. Food and Drug Administration. Products and treatments discussed are not intended to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent disease. Make your physician aware of all nutritional supplements used and immediately notify your physician if you have any health concern or undiagnosed sign or symptom.
Let's Talk Nutrition is a health talk show that features scientists, authors, nutrition specialists, personal trainers, holistic healers, and experts in traditional, natural, and integrative medicine. Listen for a chance to win daily prizes and follow Let's Talk Nutrition on Facebook and Instagram at Let's Talk Nutrition or on Twitter at LTN Radio. It's time for some inspiration. Tune in to get fit and healthy. It's time to talk about nutrition. Nutrition for your body, your mind, your spirit. It's time to talk about proper exercise, stress relief, eating well, and supplementation to help. Get ready to take charge of your health because your health is your wealth and the wealth of those who care about and love you. It's time for Let's Talk Nutrition with Dr. Michael Garko. Welcome to the show.
Welcome back to Let's Talk Nutrition. And by the way, this is the Friday edition of the show, and I'm glad you could stop by. Hamilton Cabanilla is my guest. He's an educator for Enzymedica. We've been talking about enzymes in a general sense, but in a more specific sense, I wanted and I asked Hamilton if he could focus on how enzymes therapy could be important in helping people moderate some inflammation that they may have for one reason or another. And I started him off with two different points of view about it. One by Dr. Weil, who claims that, you know, it doesn't work. And then, of course, I gave him another point of view by Dr. McCullough, who says it does work. And there's research to support enzyme therapy for inflammation and for other purposes as well. It's not without the clinical trials to support it. And Hamilton explained that technology has changed. They don't use animal-based raw materials to make their enzymes. Their enzymes at Enzymedica are plant-based. And he explained why that technology or why that approach is better and how it is that the enzymes, which are proteins, are able to survive the acidity of the stomach and get into the body. Your body does make enzymes, by the way. All right? Nature has allowed us to do that, but it doesn't make all the enzymes, does it? Hamilton?
It generally, when we're young, we can deal with things. You know, little kids trip, fall, scrape their knee, and they're like good as new the next day. But again, as we age, that workforce starts reducing, so we can't keep up with the demand. So our bodies are made perfectly, you know, I think. And, you know, we can heal. But again, as age goes on, we just can't keep up with the demand.
Mm-hmm. Now, let's talk about, we haven't mentioned any specific dietary supplements from Enzymedica. In this category of proteolytic or systemic enzymes, which are taken on an empty stomach, what are some of the products that you could recommend or talk about?
Well, you mentioned the serrapeptase enzyme or serratiopeptidase enzyme. Same thing, different names for it. But we make a formula called Serragold, which is our high-potency serrapeptase formula. Phenomenal support, again, for, you know, inflammatory modulation in the body. We also make a different formula called Repairgold, which has serrapeptase, but it also adds bromelain, papain, also proteolytics, as we mentioned before, kind of our high potency inflammation formula. So those are the two main formulas we've kind of developed to kind of help and support that inflammation modulation, you know, give the body more workers to care for your inflammation.
And the name of the second product was?
Repair Gold.
And that, I took four of those this morning as I walked out the door on an empty stomach.
Nice. The
Repairgold. And I'm going to do a little bit of experimenting with myself now over the next couple of weeks and see what kind of an effect I can get. So those are the two, Repairgold and what the first one was called?
Sarah, S S-E-R-R-A, Sarah Gold.
That's a playoff of serrapeptase, right?
Correct.
Right. Now, what would happen if you took the those systemic enzymes and you ate something? What would they function as digestive enzymes then?
They'll do some work digestively, but again, they're really targeted to work in the pH of your blood, so you'll get some support, but really that's not their main function. That's mm-hmm. not their main job. So you'll get some help, but really you want to do the best you can to take them away from food, which is simply an hour before a meal or 2 hours after. That way they get in your bloodstream, do their work. But if you take them with food, yeah, you'll get some support.
Mm-hmm. Do you all have, you're a big company, do people write to the company or call the company and talk about their experience with these products?
Oh, all the time with the different formulas. The autism community, we get so many different testimonials. But different guidelines now in this country, FDA guidelines, kind of limit as to what we can print or even share. As far as these testimonials, but absolutely the changes in people's lives, from something as simple as a digestive enzyme is sometimes unbelievable, what the testimonials you hear from people, how it just absolutely changes their life.
Mm-hmm. What happens to the enzymes when people cook food?
Gone, denatured, changed. Basically, like we talked about earlier, all enzymes have a specific shape. Once you cook it or expose it to that high temperature, that shape starts bending until it basically snaps, if you will. Once it snaps or breaks, the ability of that enzyme to function goes away. So any cooking, any high temperature exposure, any processing, which, again, it's what's become, of most of our food. Everything is canned, processed. Back in the 50s, they were paying scientists to find ways to extract the enzymes from the food so it would last longer on shelves. Crazy.
Humans left to their own devices, right?
Jeez.
So is that why you have a lot of people that are into raw food? Is that one of the rationales as to why people get enamored with a raw food way of eating?
Absolutely. That is probably the main reason why they do that, because, yeah, it's easier. Those foods are pretty much digesting themselves, which is why, when we have a salad, when we have some fruit, we feel wonderful. We get energy. We don't feel lethargic like we do when we have that foot-long sandwich or that big bowl of pasta, ready to take a nap, afterward. No, we feel great. We feel energetic because it's got its enzymes. It digests itself. We absorb the nutrients, the vitamins, the energy, and feel great. With other foods, we have to produce the enzymes. Your body has to work to try to extract those nutrients, those vitamins from the food, and it takes a toll.
So you have enzymes that are found in food naturally, and then of course the body produces enzymes, the pancreas, it's found in the saliva, the stomach, the intestinal cells, and so on. And those are digestive enzymes, and it also makes some of the systemic enzymes as well?
Correct. Our pancreas pretty much is in charge of, some of the digestive ones that go into the small intestine area.
Uh-huh.
Yes, pretty much all the other systemic ones in our body, some are produced right in the cells of that organ or that area, but most of them do come from the pancreas. So if we're using so much of that enzymatic, capacity digestively, because we're just eating processed cooked foods, that's when all these other systems start getting overlooked and we start feeling other health challenges.
I see. We have one more segment, then you have to leave at the bottom of the hour, right?
Yes, about 10:30 or so, 10:40.
Were you headed to the beach to drink pina coladas?
Hey, somebody's got to do it.
They will not find Hamilton at the beach drinking pina coladas. He's got things to do. So we'll cut him loose at the bottom of the hour. I'm not picking on you today. I just like to have fun with you.
I appreciate it.
Where are you today, by the way?
Down in the office, actually.
Where? Where?
Lots of work. Venice, Florida.
Oh, you're in Venice. Oh, you're where all the big money is, right? All that wealth.
It's around me. It's around me, but not in my pocket.
We'll be back.
Are you suffering from those awful allergies? Hay fever, sneezing, watery eyes. Here's some advice you won't want to miss.
I'm a doctor, and my patients used to dread allergy season. But then I discovered A. Vogel Allergy Relief, a unique combination of natural ingredients that usually addresses every one of my patients' symptoms. And while it's clear that the vast majority of my patients benefit significantly from A. Vogel Allergy Relief, what's even more amazing is that after using it, at least half of my patients' symptoms didn't return. As a doctor, that's the kind of outcome my patients and I can appreciate.
Get doctor-recommended A. Vogel Allergy Relief for your allergy symptoms. It's proven safe, it doesn't make you drowsy, it's fast-acting, and it may even help prevent your allergies from returning. Available at Vitamin Discount Centers, Richards, Rollin' Oats, Vitamin Shop, Nutrition Smart, and other fine health food stores.
Still looking for your fountain of youth? It's Zinnia. Look no further than the beauty aisle of your favorite health and nutrition store. Zinnia is the newest product from Form Essentials, the brand that brought you Solace. So you know it's filled with the highest quality ingredients. Many cosmetic products only treat topically, while Zinnia addresses aging and hair loss from within. Formulated to support the growth of radiant hair, skin, and nails, Zinnia is sure to help you turn back the hands of time and assist you in aging gracefully. Zinnia provides a spectrum of key vitamins and other evidence-based natural ingredients such as alpha lipoic acid, biotin, and collagen and elastin peptides, all combined in one capsule for your convenience. By promoting beauty from the inside out, you're strengthening your cells and creating a lasting enhancement to your natural beauty. Zinnia fits into your daily routine and can be taken to boost your current cosmetic products. Available now at leading health and nutrition stores, ask for Zinnia by name. Start taking Zinnia hair, skin, and nails today and get ready to look amazing.
When you're passionate about your health, that passion leads to the knowledge that exercise and a healthy diet are not always enough. Sometimes you need the extra nutritional boost that only supplements can provide. If you are looking for the leading national brands of vitamins, supplements, health and beauty, weight loss, or sports nutrition products, look no further than Vitamin Discount Center. Voted Best Independent Chain by Vitamin Retailer Magazine, Vitamin Discount Center has been a trusted and valuable nutrition resource to the Tampa Bay area for over 15 years. With daily savings up to 50%, Vitamin Discount Center offers the best prices on the highest quality nutritional supplements. Not only will you find unbeatable value, your visit includes access to a staff educated on the application of products to help equip you with the products and information you need to proactively improve your health. To locate the store nearest you, visit vitamindiscountcenter.com, as well as access to articles on popular health topics, promotions, events, and thousands of products to shop from right at home. Your search for an affordable solution to better health is finally over. Vitamin Discount Center. For life, for less.
The ever-increasing stress and toxicity we are exposed to from our environment, diets, and lifestyles make internal cleansing a necessary part of a good health regimen. Founded in 1980, Yerba Prima was the first company to launch a whole-body internal cleansing kit. Since that time, they have continued to develop and manufacture a complete range of all-natural, high-quality fiber and internal cleansing products. By using all-natural psyllium fiber and no harmful stimulant laxatives, all Yerba Prima fiber and internal cleansing products can be used over a long period of time to ensure optimal health and regularity. With nearly 30 years dedicated to all-natural cleansing products, it's easy to see why Yerba Prima is a leader in the fiber and cleansing products category. Learn more at yerbaprima.com, YERBAPRIMA.com, or visit your local health retailer. Yerba Prima, pioneer in internal cleansing products.
Let's Talk Nutrition is brought to you by Now Foods. Our products work. American Biotech Labs, your daily immune system support. Renew Life, the digestive care company. Country Life, a leader and authority in natural health and nutrition. Enzymedica, the enzyme experts. Nutrix Hawaii, more nutrition, better health, purely Hawaiian. North American Urban Spice, the only oregano oil you can take on a daily basis. Let's Talk Nutrition on the web at letstalknutrition.com. We're back from the break, so let's rejoin Dr. Michael Garko.
Welcome back. Welcome to Let's Talk Nutrition, wherever and however you may be listening or watching the show, and whatever you may be doing. 877-897-8255. That's toll-free. Call anytime you like. My guest is Hamilton Cabanilla, and we found out today that his name, his first name, Hamilton, was the name of a street in New York. Cabanilla, not so much. Welcome back, Hamilton. I want to
thank you.
I think, you know, I Carlos Cabanilla works for me, man. When I look at, I'm looking at your image on the screen here, and you look like Carlos Cabanilla to me.
I like that. Play for the Tampa Bay Rays.
Play for the Rays or the Yankees. You're, you know, big hitter. Yeah, that's you, man. There you go.
There you go.
Yeah, now I've renamed you. I'm sure that your parents will be just happy to hear that. You take enzymes?
Absolutely, my friend. Absolutely. I think it's a foundational thing for one doctor called it, it's a price of admission for life, pretty much.
That's pretty clever. Have you used enzymes in the way that we've been focusing on today, systemically, to help with inflammation and things like that? Have you ever tried that?
Oh, absolutely. I'm no spring chicken. But I love to stay active. You know, I play volleyball, basketball, you name it, you know, and it's supportive in recovering faster, because that's what affects, you know, even professional athletes, where, man, all they do is, you know, train, eat well, all these different things, but age catches up with everybody. They just can't heal as fast, and that's why they need to retire from professional sports. Enzymes just, again, give you more little workers to just recover a bit faster, so they're phenomenal.
You know, I wonder how many athletes really are aware of how they could use enzymes to help with injury and keep the inflammation down in their body. I wonder. I don't know. I don't know if there's a...
In Europe, believe it or not, in Europe, I mean, the Olympic team, you know, professional teams, they all use enzymes, you know. But here in the U.S., yeah, I don't know how aware they are. But in Europe, it's like, you know, a common thing. Here's your enzymes, here's your vitamins, pretty much.
Do you happen to know off the top of your head, I can't remember the name of his book, Dr. Howe, that, you know, he's considered the father of enzymes. I'm sure he wrote more than one. Is there one that he's really noted for? I didn't have a chance to check that.
Yeah, it's called Enzyme Nutrition.
Have you read that?
Yes.
What's your take on it?
Oh, phenomenal information for, you know, the time where he was, you know, finding out all these amazing things about enzymes, you know, with the limited technology, you know, back in those days. It is phenomenal what he finds out, the connections he makes between life and, you know, enzymes. Just remarkable information.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's interesting how pioneers like that, they're so smart, you know, and they're working. They don't have the benefit of all the technology we have now. All they had was their brains, their imagination, and a lot of drive and, you know, the determination to figure things out, right?
It's true. It's amazing. And on that, you know, one of the foundations where, again, he always would bring it back, you know, it began with digestion. So for inflammation, we talked about how we can support, you know, inflammation, again, with those systemic formulas. But again, taking care of digestion, preventing those undigested food particles from entering the bloodstream and triggering inflammatory reactions, that in itself does wonders for so many people. Taking care of digestion, again, affects so many other systems, including inflammation.
In case you're wondering, Dr. Edward Howe was born in Chicago, Illinois, on October 30th, 1898. He eventually got his medical license, and he joined the staff at Lindlar. Lindlar was a famous person in medicine, too. Lindlar Sanitarium in Elmhurst, Illinois, and he worked there until 1930. And then he went into private practice. 44 years until he retired in 1970. So, you know, he lived a good while. The guy is legendary in the world of natural medicine. Those kind of people always intrigue me, Hamilton. They make for interesting narratives. Someday we'll have to talk more about Dr. Howe. So the two products that you mentioned earlier to be used systemically are the Repair Gold and the Sarah Gold. Those two are specifically designed to be used as systemic enzymes, correct?
Correct. Empty stomach, enter the bloodstream, and they go to work.
Mm-hmm. In your experience with reducing the inflammation, how long did you stay on the enzyme therapy to reduce a certain amount of inflammation for a certain injury or whatever? How long do you usually stay on that therapy?
You usually start seeing results. I mean, it depends how long the injury or whatever is going on. But usually you'll start seeing changes at least in a week or two. You know, if it's a newer injury, again, just working out or you know, anything you fell in on the volleyball court, basketball court, you know, by the next day you start seeing changes. So, you know, it just depends how long it's been,
sure,
around. Is it, you know, something systemic, you know, something a little more chronic, or is it something, yeah, just an injury that just occurred?
I got you.
You know, or you can take it on an ongoing basis. I mean, that's what I do. I
sure
don't wait for an injury to happen.
We're almost out. We're gone. And he's gone, and we'll be back. And just ahead, I'll talk about sugar tax.
Looking for the perfect complement to your beauty regimen? Try Form Essentials Zinnia. The finest of its kind, Zinnia offers twice as much biotin as other formulas, which has proven to unlock the vibrancy in even the dullest of hair, skin, and nails. Zinnia breaks through and rejuvenates cells internally, helping you achieve the allure of effortless beauty. Reviving your hair, skin, and nails has never been easier. This essential blend of biotin, alpha lipoic, and hyaluronic acid, collagen, and vitamin C creates lasting enhancements to your natural good looks. Don't go on wondering, you're worth the results. This combination of ingredients can only be found in Zinnia. Pamper yourself with a proven bit of affordable luxury and start looking your best. Ask for Zinnia by name at your nearest vitamin retailer to begin your journey to restored nails, head-turning hair, and radiant skin today. For more information, visit formessentials.com.
When your alarm goes off, do you jump out of bed with excitement? Or does it take multiple alarms, a few snooze buttons, or a morning caffeine fix to get you going? These habits and daily stress cause a vicious cycle in which sleep becomes increasingly elusive. In fact, 54% of Americans report struggles to fall or stay asleep. For a better night's rest, look no further than Solace, an all-natural dietary supplement that supports healthy sleep and relaxation, so you get the rest you need to wake up clear-eyed, alert, and ready for the day. Solace has given thousands a better night's rest and the power to take back their mornings while enjoying the day ahead of them. Solace is formulated with non-addictive, scientifically proven, all-natural ingredients that support sleep and relaxation, such as melatonin, tryptophan, and 5-HTP. For more information or to order Solace, visit TakeSolace.com. Solace, for healthy sleep, naturally.
Let's Talk Nutrition is brought to you by Nubian Heritage, Global Healing, Modern Wellness, BSN, Finish First, Nordic Naturals, Pure and Great Tasting Omega Oils, Jaro Formulas, Superior Nutrition and Formulation, Natural Factors, Where Great Health Begins, Kyolic, Aging Makes the Finest Garlic Truly Odorless, A. Vogel, Europe's Leading Brand of Herbal Medicine, Let's Talk Nutrition, on the web at letstalknutrition.com. We're back from the break, so let's rejoin Dr. Michael Garko.
Welcome back. Welcome to Let's Talk Nutrition, wherever and however you may be listening or watching the show and whatever you may be doing. I'm going to talk about sugar tax. Caught my attention. There was a story trending this morning out of the University of Queensland in Australia, the Queensland School of Public Health. And then I started digging around a little bit more. And I thought, well, let me develop this theme a little bit. Let's talk about it. Some people get very upset when they start taxing food, taxing sugar, taxing this and taxing that. Having trouble with my voice. And so this, let me just set it up this way. Let me tell you about this particular article that I was reading coming out of the University of Queensland School of Public Health. And what they're saying is that the sugary drinks tax, the sugary drink tax, would provide big benefits for people. Okay. And the authors of the study said a 20% tax on sugar sweetened beverages would result, I'm quoting them, in widespread, long lasting public health benefits and significant health costs. Health cost savings, close quote. And so they were predicting that what they found in their study, they used a particular modeling a model. I won't get into all of that, but the modeling scoped the effects of the of sugar over the life the sugar tax over the lifetime of adult Australians alive in 2010, Dr. Veerman said. And he said that, quote, we found there would be 800 fewer new type 2 diabetes cases each year once the tax was introduced. He said further, after 25 years, about 1,600 fewer deaths would occur annually, with heart disease accounting for the largest share of this postponed mortality, close quote. So there seems to be a body of evidence that's accumulating to suggest that if they tax these sugar-sweetened beverages, there's going to be some health benefit. There's two ways to do the tax. You can tax the end product, which you and I will pay for when we buy the product, or you tax the companies who are making the product, and you tax them based upon how much sugar they're putting into the product. And what the experts argue is that when you take that approach, that seems to, many experts seem to believe that's a better approach. And it seems also then to encourage these manufacturers to come up with other, to make products that have less sugar in them so that they don't get taxed. And they find alternative sweeteners, perhaps like stevia, which I talked about on my show just yesterday. Sweet Leaf Stevia, by the way, nice company, make good products. So this whole idea of taxing these beverages seems to be gaining some support and some merit. Worldwide, there are an estimated almost 2 billion adults that are overweight, and of those, 600 million are obese. So we have a global epidemic of people being overweight or obese. And believe you me, as I've reported numerous times on this show, researchers and experts and whomever is involved in all of this is trying to figure out how do we abate, slow down, or otherwise turn this epidemic around. Now, here's a piece of evidence to suggest that the tax works. Mexico, what became in January of 2014, I remember reporting on this, became the first country to do a nationwide sugar sweetened drink tax when it introduced a tax of 1 peso per liter, which is around 10% of the price. The Mexican tax beverage or soda tax included all drinks that have been sweetened using sugar, not just carbonated drinks. That would be juices, sports drinks, whatever. Any drink that had sugar in it. And they did it for a good reason. Mexico consumes more sugar-sweetened beverages than any other country on the planet. When they just took a look at Coca-Cola products alone, just Coca-Cola, Mexicans consume 745 servings per person per year of Coca-Cola compared to the worldwide average of 94. I guess they like their Coke, their Coca-Cola. My God. The average person they found just with Coca-Cola products, 745 servings per year. The early results from the imposition of the tax would suggest that this tax on these sweetened beverages, no matter what they are, sodas, juices, whatever, is having an impact and reducing consumption of these sugary drinks in Mexico. They have a big time, no pun intended, obesity epidemic problem there. They surpassed us. We're no longer number one. Mexico is now number one for obesity. So I guess we don't have to be number one in everything, right? What do you think about that? What do you think about taxing these beverages? You know, I've gone back and forth on this, and I said I have to, before I formulate a final opinion about it or, you know, really come down one way or another, I wanted to see if taxing these beverages would have, one, any benefit in moderating people's behaviors and getting them to drink less of these sugary drinks. And it seems that that's happening to some extent. Now, I was trying to find the list. I don't know if Stephen can find it or not. I was trying to find the list of states in the United States that have a soda tax. Don't they have a soda tax in, I don't know of any state that where there's a statewide tax on either cities like New York.
I think New York had one for the size, like, you know, those paint bucket ones, like they were they were charging, there was going to be a like a surplus tax on the size of the actual drink, not all of them, but just a particular size. I can't remember if that actually went through or not. I'll take a look here as we get into the break.
This is interesting. What would happen if somebody proposed introduced a national soda tax? I wonder what would happen.
Riots
in the streets. LTN Health Question. We'll be right back.
Hi, I'm Dr. Michael Murray with a minute of important health news. One of my all-time favorite natural products is a special extract of licorice known as DGL. DGL is short for deglyceryzinated licorice, but I tell my patients that it stands for darn good licorice. DGL is made by removing the compound in licorice that can raise blood pressure in some people. Double-blind clinical studies have shown DGL is quite useful in healing stomach and intestinal ulcers. In fact, in head-to-head studies, it has actually outperformed popular anti-ulcer drugs. But rather than inhibit the release of stomach acid, DGL stimulates the normal defense mechanisms that prevent ulcer formation and promote healing. Clinical studies have not only shown DGL to be extremely effective, but also that it is completely without side effects. Clearly, DGL is a better choice.
Feeling tired after your meal? Occasional gas, bloating, or indigestion at inopportune times? You may have an enzyme deficiency. Did you know that many common digestive discomforts can be caused by poor digestion? When food isn't completely digested, it begins to ferment in the digestive tract, which may cause uncomfortable symptoms. Digest Gold, America's number one selling enzyme product, offers unparalleled support for your digestive needs. It contains exclusive blends of enzymes optimized to be 3 times stronger and work more than 6 times faster than other leading digestive supplements. With just 1 capsule per meal, Digest Gold offers support to break down carbohydrates, fats, fiber, and protein. Enzymedica products are all natural, vegetarian, contain absolutely no fillers, and are vegan and kosher when possible. You'll find Digest Gold and other Enzymedica products at fine health food stores near you. These statements have not been evaluated by the Food and Drug Administration. This product is not intended to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent any disease.
At Country Life Vitamins, we've been helping people live happy, healthy lives since 1971, and we believe integrity should always be our number one ingredient. We are committed to this belief because you deserve high-quality nutrition, specifically crafted with the highest standards to support your health. Country Life's manufacturing facility is an NSF GMP-registered facility, as well as USDA-certified organic, so you can feel good about the products you're taking. Country Life Vitamins is also the first supplement company in the United States to have a complete line of products certified gluten-free. That's over 500 products. Country Life Vitamins' pledge of integrity is based on 5 standards: authenticity, cleanliness, freshness, consistency, and accuracy. Ask for Country Life's top-selling products, such as Coenzyme B Advanced for increased energy or Flexable for joint health. Country Life Vitamins' commitment to ensure all of our products are pure, wholesome, gluten-free supplements full of natural goodness provides peace of mind with the knowledge you are using a brand you can trust.
Energy, energy, and more energy. Everyone needs it. But did you know you can get the energy you need quick through the powers of wild forest extracts? Wild chaga and birch bark were a secret source of energy and power for Russian athletes years ago, making them unbeatable. Now you too can experience real energy and power like you've never dreamed possible. Wild chaga is the world's top source of SOD, superoxide dismutase, that critical enzyme that blocks the aging process and keeps your cells healthy. Wild birch extract is the world's top source of betulin, a natural sterol needed by every cell of the body. And healthy cells mean a healthy you and a more powerful one too. Chaga birch bark is also good for your heart, healthy cholesterol, and even helps build healthy arteries. No wonder it's known as the king of all herbs. So take your Chaga Charge tea with wild birch bark every day and Chaga Max capsules from North American Herb and Spice and get that maximum energy you need. Also available in liquid as Chago Power Drops. These statements have not been evaluated by the Food and Drug Administration. These products are not intended to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent any disease.
At Canavest, we believe that the future of hemp is unlimited, and through innovative and responsible application in science, we will enhance the prosperity and well-being of our customers, employees, and communities. As pioneers, our long-term goal at Canavest is to locate hemp seed processing mills near to our future family of hemp farmers. These local factories will convert hemp seed into nutritious oil, protein powders, bread flour, and hemp meal. Canavest supports local efforts and believes that sustainability starts locally. Canavest was named one of the Nutritional Outlook's Best of 2014, and we are committed to pioneering the hemp revolution as the world's leading producer of quality hemp-derived CBD products. Resistance to change is in great part the result of trying to do today's job with yesterday's tools and with yesterday's concepts. The hemp revolution is here, and it's up to all of us to change perception and to impact policy. Will you join us in this movement? Learn more about the education and science behind Canavest at canavest.com.
Let's Talk Nutrition is brought to you by Natrol, own your health, AlgaLife, algae for life, NeoCell, the true science of collagen, CV Sciences, from seed to shelf, New Chapter, the benefit of nature's wisdom, Yerba Prima, pioneers in internal cleansing, Form Essentials, makers of the sleep aid Solace, now introducing Zinnia for healthy hair, skin, and nails. Let's Talk Nutrition on the web at letstalknutrition.com. We're back from the break, so let's rejoin Dr. Michael Garko.
Trying to get these numbers. Here's the LTN health question of the day. Let me give you some information first and give you some guidance. I went to the Robert Wood Johnson Foundation, and they have a report called Bridging the Gap that they submitted. As of January 1st, 2014, they said that there were 34 states and the District of Columbia applied sales taxes to regular sugar-sweetened soda sold through food stores. And 39 states, and including the District of Columbia, applied sales taxes to regular sugar-sweetened soda sold through vending machines. Seven states also applied non-sales taxes, fees to bottles, syrups, and or powders, mixes at the manufacturer, distributor, wholesaler, and retailer levels. So there you can see that there's a movement afoot here to tax these sugar-sweetened beverages. A point to be made, and Stephen, one of my producers, made the point. He said, "But," and I'll give you the question in a second, of the states, the total number of states that have a state sales tax on regular sugar-sweetened soda, not all of them are using the tax as a way to deter people from drinking more soda. Some of them are only using it as a way to generate revenue. So it's not a real big tax. So here's the question. According to this report by the Robert Wood Johnson Foundation called Bridging the Gap, how many states have a state sales tax on regular sugar-sweetened soda? How many? 27, 37, or 47? I counted them. It's a long list. There's a hint. 877-897-8255. 877-897-TALK. How many states in the United States have a state sales tax on regular sugar-sweetened soda as of January 2014? 27, 37, or 47? 877-897-8255. Some people really push back hard on this whole concept. They don't like the idea that they're going to be taxed heavily. Now, some places it's only a penny. It's nothing. I mean, you probably wouldn't even recognize. You probably don't even know that you're being taxed for the soda. Many people don't even realize it. But when they start doing 10%, 15%, 20% tax on that drink, then you notice. Well, notwithstanding the pushback by consumers, it turns out that where they're introducing this concept seems to be working. In Mexico, which is a great place to test this idea, they did a nationwide sales tax of 1 peso on anything that had sugar in it. Anything added sugar got taxed. Guess what? Their consumption of sugar is going down, and maybe they're trying to get this obesity epidemic under control there. It seems to be helping. So how you may feel about the government doing that, I don't know. It would be kind of interesting. What do they do with that money? What if they use that money from the tax on these sodas or on sugar-sweetened beverages, no matter what kind of beverage? What if they use that in some health capacity, in some way to help people with their health, you know, in some health-related capacity? That would be a good idea. I'm not necessarily opposed to this idea myself. 877-897-8255. How many states have a sales tax on regular sugar-sweetened soda? I'll give you two choices, 27 or 47. And I can tell you, it's a lot of states. 877-897-8255. Josh, my other producer, was drinking, how much soda were you drinking at one point?
At least 2 20-ounce. What are they, containers? 20-ounce bottles? Yeah, the most I would drink is maybe a 2-liter.
And you quit?
Yeah, cold turkey.
Cold turkey. Yep. How long now have you gone without drinking soda?
Oh, man.
2 weeks?
Well over a month.
Well over a month?
Yeah, a month and a half, two months almost probably.
Do you miss it?
No, not at all.
It's interesting to ask the question, why were you drinking that much soda?
I don't know. I just
habit.
I guess so. I mean, I quit smoking in 2008, so I think that that may have had something to do with why I started to overconsume. But then, you know, I don't know. I started feeling really crummy, so I just stopped.
It's sort of when you started.
You got into my brain too.
Well, you were hanging around the show, helping with the production of the streaming for the show. So you were hearing me report on this. Apparently, had some influence on you.
Oh yeah, for sure, definitely.
That's good.
I'm glad I made the choice too. And it's not.
Do you feel better? Do you notice any difference?
Yes. You kidding?
Really?
Yeah. And I also feel the difference when I do get caffeine, because you know that's a lot of caffeine I don't get regularly.
Right.
So when I drink coffee, man, that coffee is way more effective. Yes.
Yeah, it takes a little less to get that brain.
Oh yeah, for sure.
Cooking. Let's go to Lutz, Florida. Lutz. Yeah, we haven't heard from Lutz in a long time. Patricia, welcome to Let's Talk Nutrition.
Patricia H. Paytner. I'm a long-time listener of Dr. Garko. Well, long time.
Well, thank you so much. We appreciate that. I used to live in Lutz.
Oh, it's a great place to live.
Yeah. I remember a time when, you know, the jokes were there was only a red light in Lutz. Now
we have 99,000 vehicles going by 54 and 41 intersection. And I live on 54, so I can tell you the traffic is immense.
It's intense. So how many states have this sales tax on regular soda, 27 or 47?
Yeah, 47.
47, yeah. I counted them here off this report by Robin
Woodjar. I have a hearing problem, and I misheard Dr. Garko.
No, you got it. You got it right, 47. Listen, thank you so much, Patricia, for listening to the show. We appreciate your listenership. And I'm glad that you won the $25 gift card.
Because I need something from the health store.
There you go. We helped you out, and we're happy to do it. And thank you so much for listening, and I appreciate it. And thank you for listening and watching the show. I have a lot of faults. Taking people for granted is not one of them, especially those who listen and watch this show. I'm very much dialed into your support, and I really do appreciate it. Keep in mind, your health is your wealth. Have a wonderful, lovely weekend.